Here we go. Okay. Hey.
Hi.
We're talking about drinks. Like,
fuck yeah, we're talking about drinks. Is that shocking to everybody that we're talking about fucking drinks?
Because we just drink wine now, and so we don't really have a drink hardly ever.
No.
Even after I actually put a bar in my house.
I have a bar, too.
You do have a bar.
And I don't mix drinks either. And I don't. I have all the drink glasses.
And you do.
Yeah.
And I have all the stuff, too.
I just dusted them all.
No, you did.
2 days ago, because they never get used.
You know what? We should just pick a night to have like drinks.
Cocktails.
Like cocktails, not just wine, because all we drink is wine. We should have like cocktails, because they are fun.
They are fun.
They are fun.
We could have a cocktail party.
We could look at some new recipes and find some really cute.
Have our friends over.
Like when we had that tailgate party and I made that harvest margarita, that was so good.
That was actually really good.
That was really good.
That was a fun party.
That was a really fun party. I miss that. Yeah.
We're going to have to come up with more ideas like that, seeing how Thor's put the axe down on us.
Yes.
Our,
he put his foot down.
My first husband and Kobe's second husband has put his foot down because we want, Kobe and I have too expensive taste on experiences.
Yeah. We want to go do all this stuff. And he was like, listen. We cannot afford to do all these things. So we already have one trip planned in October and then the next one in the first week of February. That's it.
That's,
so from now until then,
we can't do anything else.
There's nothing else. You can't go anyplace else. We have to be on the cheap.
That's what he's told us.
So we're trying to think of cheap things to do.
Yeah, we are. We are. So tailgate party is cheap.
Tailgating party is cheap.
Barbecues? Cheap.
Barbecues are cheap. So the expensive part comes when we want to actually go somewhere and like stay somewhere else.
Yes. Well, that's why I was trying to get the free Mariner tickets for us through his work.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because we could do a day trip.
We could do a day trip.
We don't have to stay there.
No, we don't. We can just go.
And the ticket's free.
And the tickets are free.
And then
we have to pay for parking for like $20. And then.
No, that's $20 you prepay.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
fucking $50. We paid $50 the last time we went. Free tickets,
what?
But $50 to park in that same garage that you guys got. Because I told Thor, because I had just bought the tickets for Jack.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh,
$20.
We get there and it's $50. So if you get it before, you get a $30 discount, basically.
Damn.
That's why I was
like
yesterday,
literally $50 to let your car sit.
Yeah, and be babysat by no one that actually cares about
Nobody
it.
Nobody looks after
no
it.
No one actually cared about it.
No, they don't come in, like, it's not secure. It's not.
Like, for $50, there should be an armed guard sitting in front
there
of my car.
There should be.
In a little chair
yeah.
with a gun.
Yeah.
And a taser.
Yeah. For $50.
Yes, that's what should happen. And we only stayed, you know us.
Yeah.
Well, it was very uncomfortable. It was a Blue Jay game.
So?
We were outnumbered.
Really?
Blue Jays are the Canadian team.
It's Toronto, but really?
Oh, maybe. What? Okay, I don't know. But yeah, we were outnumbered.
No shit. Really?
Like, I heard Jeff was the one that told us don't go to the Blue Jay game.
Oh, really?
Because for that reason, you don't feel like you're going to a home game.
But how far is Toronto away from Seattle?
Really far? That's New York.
Why do they fucking come to Seattle?
I don't know. I thought the baseball team was right across the border.
No.
Don't understand
nope,
that.
Nope, nope.
I don't get it, though, because when we walked in there, we had, you know, the seats we get for Thor's work, really good seats.
Yeah, first level, right?
First level.
Yeah.
And, well, no, it's, yeah, first level, 11 rows up from the bottom.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
But we're really close to the bottom. You know, when we went, we were about that same spot. That's where we are, third baseline.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Okay.
That's where their season tickets are. So we're sitting there and we're surrounded by nothing but Blue Jay fans.
That's so weird.
To the point where we were thankful we didn't wear Mariners outfits. Remember, I was going to borrow a shirt from you
because
I don't have any Mariners gear.
And I have lots.
Yes. And, but we forgot the last minute. I didn't get it. If things happen on Thursdays when we drink.
Yeah. Yeah.
It just
happens.
Fine. So
shit happens.
It does. So we were thankful. So we sat down. We're literally, there's not another Mariners fan in sight. We can't see one.
That's so weird.
So we're starting to watch the game and the Mariners do something okay. And Thor kind of cheers for them. And then everyone looks at him like,
oh, man.
So after that,
how did you guys get in the Blue Jay section? That's so weird.
The whole thing was Blue Jay section.
That's
because
so weird.
When the Mariners things, anything the Mariners did, there was hardly, it was like crickets.
What?
They like sell it out with the Blue Jay fans.
That's so weird. It's
pretty much the season's pass.
I've never heard of this. That's so weird.
Jeff heard of it. You should talk to Jeff about it, because
I don't know.
When he asked us about the game, and I told him, he's like, oh yeah, Blue Jays.
Blue Jays.
He's like, I would never go to a Blue Jays game. I'm like, oh shit. Okay. Yeah. We won again. So I ended up cheering for the Blue Jays because it was just easier. Be like, oh yeah, good job, Blue Jays.
Okay, here
Mariners
we go.
Suck. Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, so it's the two innings in, Thor and I were done.
Yeah. Two innings. Two.
Done. $50, not worth it.
Oh no.
We should have left it with the homeless person and just prayed.
Damn, that's too bad. That's
so then
really
we went
bad.
On a mission to find the peanuts in the bag, not in the fucking prepackaged shit.
Oh, the hot ones.
Yes.
The hot ones.
Only one place sold them in the whole place. It took us another hour to find those.
Oh,
after
damn.
Asking all these different people are like, we wouldn't even care about the game at this point. We're just trying to find some fucking peanuts.
I just want the peanuts, man.
Well, they were like, well, there's these. I'm
now,
like,
was
we don't-
this after we went?
Yes.
Did you guys get helmet nachos?
No.
No? No helmet nachos?
We got literally nothing but the peanuts. I think Thor got a beer. I did not get a drink because
wow,
I was so uncomfortable.
Wow.
It was really uncomfortable.
See, the ballpark is one of my happy places. I don't have very many happy places.
You don't.
I literally
you
have
don't.
Like
Disneyland and a ballpark.
Disneyland, the ballpark, the lodge, and the beach. That's it.
I like
that's
the beach. It. I'm your happy place too.
You are. You're my happy place.
Yes, yes.
I'm usually always happy.
I know. I'm always happy when I'm with you. So I
but
think
the last time we were at the ballpark, I guess it's been 2 years now because
yes,
we couldn't go last year.
We couldn't
year.
Go last year. Nope.
I discovered the vodka lemonade stand and that changed my life.
I wanted the vodka lemonade because I told Thor I wanted the vodka lemonade, but then he reminded me how much I hate vodka.
But you can't taste it.
It
just tastes like lemonade.
Everybody says you can't taste it, but I can always taste the fucking vodka
since
the
Patrick. Yeah.
I can smell it from probably 10 feet away. I can smell this
well,
vodka coming out.
When I was... This sounds bad. When I was in high school, not high school, I guess it was college.
There we go. That's a little better.
First year of college, I went camping with some friends of mine and we discovered mixing pink lemonade with vodka. We had never done it before, but we thought we had invented this.
Oh, God.
And we called it a pink goofy. A pink goofy.
I kind of love that.
That thing. Was the name of the drink is that's what we called
cute.
It. We drank pink goofies. And so that's always what I call it. Vodka with pink lemonade. I call it a pink goofy.
I love that.
And so because we thought we invented it. I'm sure someone had invented it before. But
no one had came up with a pink goofy.
Anywho. Yeah. Vodka lemonade. Mariner dog. Garlic fry.
Ooh. And helmet. Nachos.
Helmet nachos. Sitting in the sun. That's my happy place.
I actually had the best time at a Mariners game when I went with you.
That was
we had
something
such
else.
A good day.
I know we've talked about it on here before.
Oh my God.
But yeah.
That was such a good day.
It was so fun.
I mean, highlights are nachos off the floor.
Eating nachos off the ground.
Yeah, literally off the cement
literally
ground.
Literally off the ground.
Not the ones that touch the ground.
Touching my hand in the dirt.
Oh my God.
Of the field.
That, I have a picture of that.
And the security guy letting me do it.
Yes. We asked him point blank.
Yeah. He was fine. I didn't crawl over the thing.
No, he was
fine. I just put my hand down. It was fine.
It's amazing how people will let you do stuff when you
and
ask them.
That's the trip we got our snorts too. Yes.
Because we were showing the snorts.
We had the snorts
in
the game.
Our hands.
The snorts are little tiny beanie baby
little
bowls that we got in our McDonald's Happy Meals on
that
the way
day.
To the ballpark.
Yes. And they and have traveled to multiple places
they
since.
Always go with us now. Yeah.
They usually have to go.
They do.
At least one of them makes it most time both.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, one of us forgets to pack.
Yeah,
one.
It's usually me.
I wasn't going to go there.
It's always me.
It's not always. Ugh. I thought I forgot it once.
You might have. I can't remember where you were, though.
But I think we both forgot them.
Yeah.
That time. But I did forget it once. We have to bring the snorts and the bunnies.
And the bunnies. Yeah, we got free bunnies at Build-A-Bear one time. I don't know how.
I don't know why they wouldn't give it to kids.
I know, right?
That's why it was so shocking. They're like, you guys need to have these.
Hey, these have been opened. You guys want them? We're like, what is it? It's like a mystery, like a mini mystery animal thing. And they gave it to us. And we both got these little bunnies. I'm like, I can't believe they just gave these to us.
Little floppy ear bunnies.
Oh, my gosh. That was amazing.
Well, we're going to be going to the Laugh Riot tonight.
We're going to the Laugh Riot. It's going to be fun. We're going to get a nice...
It's not free.
I'm assuming it'll be nice.
It better be nice.
Prime rib dinner.
Kobe and I will be drinking and possibly not eating our prime rib dinner. It just depends how this shit comes out. We're not meat eaters. We actually don't like meat.
Especially beef. I don't like it because cows are my friend and I like cows.
I love cows too. And I only eat poultry. We're poultry-tarians.
Yes, poultry-tarians.
With a little bit of crab going in and shrimp.
We decided we wanted to eat more fish.
We're going to eat seafood.
We're going to try seafood.
We're going to try some fish and chips.
Fish and chips. We're going to do crab cakes.
And shrimp.
I'm still hesitant on the shrimp.
I'm hesitant on the fish and chips. So okay. If I do the fish and chips, you do the shrimp.
Okay. I will try it.
Or you know what we could do? You do fish and chips and I do shrimp and
chips. We could do that.
Wait, shrimp and chips.
Chips.
Yeah. That doesn't sound good together.
It doesn't.
Shrimp and chips.
Aren't you supposed to have like popcorn shrimp or something?
Yes. It'd be popcorn, shrimp, and fries.
And fries.
That sounds better
than chips. And I'll do fish and chips.
Yeah.
And because, you know, really... anything that's battered and deep fried is inherently good to start with.
That's why I think you'll be okay with shrimp.
I've had...
like coconut shrimp and stuff.
Calamari.
And you like that?
And, well, it was deep fried, battered and deep fried. You couldn't tell. It tasted like anything else is battered and deep fried.
True. Calamari, deep fried green bean.
Yeah. It's like, you know what? Thing. It's all good. So, you know.
So, Thor is going to want some avocado fries soon.
Oh, we can make them.
I know you can. That's why I'm telling you this.
Okay, yeah.
He wants them.
Okay, again. We can do that.
I know.
We totally can do that.
You know what we should do? You know how you made that one pork for the tacos that one time?
Yes.
I think we could recreate that. So we need some cabbage. Some kind of we'll go on the menu and we'll look
at... You mean those carnitas that I made?
Yes.
Okay.
So we're going to recreate the Bookwalter taco. Because
it was a pork taco.
It's a pork taco.
Okay.
With an avocado fry in there. There was cabbage, but they did more of the purple cabbage in it.
Okay.
I'm not sure why, but it was mostly the purple stuff in there.
Okay.
And then there was some kind of a glaze. Balsamic glaze.
A balsamic, like vinaigrette glaze.
Yes.
Like,
there was a glaze they stuffed on there.
Yeah. I'm down with that.
There wasn't much else, I don't think.
Okay, we can do that.
Oh, and then, you know, little tomatoes and stuff like that.
Tomato, like little
pico type
little
stuff.
Little pico thing. Yeah. Okay.
And then the avocado fry was the crown jewel inside of it.
Damn. Okay. All right. We can do that.
You saw the pictures.
Yes, I did.
I told Thor, I was like, if we tell Kobe about it, she'll make this thing.
I will totally make that.
I did not do the pineapple thing at Sterling.
You didn't?
No.
Why?
Because I just didn't.
Okay.
Because Thor wanted Anthony's.
Okay. Well.
So I had crab cakes.
Those were good though, you said.
They were really good. Like,
you know what? I think I like crab cakes.
I think the next time we go to the lodge, that's an easy meal. We walk over there and we get some crab cakes. It will be an expensive meal, but I almost wonder if we'll do better with that than letting them create something for us at the lodge, which we don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
It was a good experience for once.
It was. They did an awesome job.
Yes.
But yeah, I think we should go.
I think we should try Anthony's.
The crab cake thing. And I'm totally getting some fish and chips.
Ooh.
Doing it.
We can share. Well, one will get crab cakes because the crab cakes is a little expensive.
Isn't that like an appetizer though?
No.
Oh, it's not? It's like
a meal?
But
we can add on a crab cake to any meal. For like $12.
For one?
$38 for two.
$38 for two crab cakes.
Well, you get other shit with it. You get vegetables, potatoes, and something else.
That seems like a lot.
It is a lot. But
like a lot.
They're like this big. The crab cake was this big. Mm. And I've had crab cakes before, and there's usually a lot of like other fillers in there. This one was pure crab.
Oh, okay. That might be why I liked it though, because it had all the filling.
This was the best crab cake I've ever had.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah, you would love it. And I only ate one. I ended up bringing one home.
Okay.
But then Thor got, you saw that charred little piece of... You didn't even know what the fuck that was.
It looked like a piece of charcoal.
What the fuck's wrong with me? I keep saying fuck today. A lot.
I have no fucking idea what the fuck is wrong with you.
Have you noticed that? I mean, no. I drop fuck a lot, but today's a little bit more.
I haven't noticed.
I probably didn't tell you. Because,
what?
Oh, full off the subject.
What?
Oh my God.
You didn't tell me what?
I had a massage this morning. I got my first massage that hurt me.
What?
In my whole life.
Where did it hurt?
Well, everywhere she touched me.
Are you fucking serious?
Yes, I told her that no one can rub deep enough on me.
Yeah, I've heard you say that to every massage person.
Every single one. I was like, and you cannot hurt me. Go ahead and try.
And she did?
Holy shit. I had to tell her twice. Okay, I actually need you to lighten up on that pressure. She's like, oh, no problem, honey. Like,
oh, my fuck. God.
Like, it's tender.
Whoa.
Right now, tender.
Holy shit. This is like...
I know. I can't believe I didn't tell you this when I first came in.
Exploding right now.
And she's going to be the massage therapist I'm going to go to from here on out. Anybody ever want to actually need a good massage, you go to Mary at Adam Trotter's Chiropractic. I don't think that's what it's called, but that's the duck. That's a chiropractic.
Yeah.
Guy.
Okay. All right.
Oh my God. And she was like, okay, I walked into the little room because Thor, at first, she's like, okay, who am I taking today? Because one was different from last time, and then she was the same one, and she's the one that did Thor last time. And Thor was like, you need her. She's like, she can rub almost as hard as you can.
Sweet.
That's what I was like. So she asked who was getting the deep, deep tissue, and I was like,
Right here.
So we walk in there. I'm, you know, fully clothed at this point. She's like, so let's talk about your issues. She's like, well, I do dental. She's like, okay, so upper shoulders, middle back. And she's like, do you get headaches and do your hands go numb? I was like, actually, none of those happen. Nope. You don't ever hear me complain about my hands.
Nope.
Because I work them out. I do the stretches that I beg you to do all the time.
My hands don't get numb.
Well, anyway, I guess with dental, most dental people, their hands get numb. And you lose feeling in them. So we talked about that. And then she goes, your right hand or left hand? I was like, technically, I think I'm right. Because I write right-handed, but I do almost everything else left.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. And she's like, okay, so most of your pain's on your left side. I can tell. I'm like, how can you tell? She's like, your left shoulder's slightly above your right.
It is. I'm looking at it right now.
Like this? Is it like that right now?
Yeah,
like that?
It is. Just a little bit.
Isn't that insane?
Oh, my God. That's so weird.
I'm so relaxed right now, too.
It's just a tiny bit.
That's
well,
what she
it
said.
Could be your shirt, though, because you have stripes on your shirt. But it's a tiny bit.
I did not have the shirt on this morning. I had a tank top on. And she was like, yeah, I can tell your left one's a little more. You hold that one up a higher. So I can tell that one's a little worse. I'm like, okay.
Oh, my God.
So she was so knowledgeable. And then she was like, okay, well, you know what? Don't take your pants off. I'm just working on those shoulders the whole time.
Leave pants on, honey.
She's like, what? And then she said it to them. She's like, if you're more comfortable taking them off, it's fine. But I'm not going to work down there. So you have the option of leaving them on. I'm like, all right, I'll leave them on. And it was amazing. Like, literally, there was times I had to deep breathe before I had to tell her to lighten up.
Wow. Wow.
I was very impressed.
Holy shit.
So I told Thor he can't have her back.
She's mine now.
I will be
Thank you very
I
much.
Will be keeping her. And I told him, I was like, last time I was like, you don't want to give up your girl. Don't let me have her. Because if she's that good. And Thor got a different one than I had last time. She was a little shit brick house. Shorter. But we're talking guns, men's guns on her. Totally sleeve tats. I was like, oh, yeah, she's going to do some shit to
Thor. Yeah.
She cupped him.
Oh, she did.
Yeah. Now, I can't show the camera this because Thor will get mad.
Oh, I was going to say, can't you plug it in? Don't we have it?
Oh,
no. Oh, okay.
He will get mad at me if I do that.
We'll just tell everyone about it, though.
Yeah, we'll tell everybody. It looks like I beat the fucking shit out of my husband.
Really?
Yes.
Oh. Oh, my God.
And this is 2 hours after.
Now, I've had the cupping.
You did have the
twice,
cupping.
Twice. And they never did that to me.
No.
I'd never had that.
No. And never
but
looked
usually
like that.
That's what happens though, I think, normally. Mm-hmm. But I
your skin
that never happened
that,
to me.
Your skin did not do that. No.
That looks nasty.
Doesn't look painful?
It does. It looks really painful.
I did not get cupping, but I do have bruising already.
Do you really?
They're fantastic.
Are you so excited? I'm so excited
They're
to be bruised.
So great.
Oh my God.
I'm just excited for like 2 or 3 days down the line where I hope this all feels way better.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, and she couldn't even get all of it because, I mean, this is 20 years in the making here.
Oh, yeah. It's going to take a while.
Like, I don't even know with us both doing massages that we'll even waste the money at the lodge now.
Maybe not.
Because they're $120 there.
Yeah, I know. It's way cheaper here.
You need to go to my guy now. And we're going to drop Mitch's name and then you won't have to pay.
Mitch. Much. Mitch sent me.
I'm going to get the last name.
Okay.
And then you just say, hey, yeah, my friend Mitch, blah, 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 told me I need to call you. And he's a good chiropractor, too. I'm not expecting you to switch chiropractor, but at least get the massage.
Okay. I'll think about it. I like my girl.
I like your girl, too, but you told me it's like $90.
Yeah, I know, but she does a really good job.
Kobe, look at me.
That I'm not gonna get that though. I'm not.
How do you know? How are we getting that?
I'm not gonna get it. I know it.
I'm not telling you to drop Thor's in my name. You're just dropping the same one.
I know, but it doesn't happen. That stuff doesn't happen for me. I don't get free shit.
What, really?
No.
I get a lot of
free. Never ever get free shit.
I get lots of free shit.
I never get free shit. Ever.
Well,
like my shit costs double what everybody else's shit costs. That's how it works for me.
Not when you're with me.
Not when I'm with you, but are you going to go with me every time?
Possibly.
No.
Why don't we schedule it for during my morning time when I'm at work and I have to escort you there?
We could do that.
Because you're way more important than I am at that place.
No, and I'm not.
I think you are.
I don't think I am. I don't think most people don't even know I'm there.
Whatever. The doctors know you're there. They don't give a crap. I think there's two out of the three doctors that are actually, no, two out of the four doctors, because there's two that really want me to be there. And I think there's two that don't, that they're actually really happy when I'm not.
The doctors only come to me and they want something.
That's how they are with all of us.
I guess that's true. Like, why else did they come into my office unless they wanted something?
Why do they come in my operatory? Because they want to do the exam and they want to make money. They don't want to spend time with me. It's not my winning personality that brings them in there.
All right. What was your favorite childhood video game you played?
Contra.
What's Contra?
What the fuck? You don't know what Contra is?
No.
So this is a kind of like a war game a little bit.
Okay.
It's the only war game I've ever played and liked because I don't like war games.
I've never heard of this.
So I was on my first Nintendo.
Oh, see, when I was growing up, we didn't have Nintendo because I'm that old.
Well, Thor didn't have Nintendo
either. We had Atari.
That's what Thor had, was an Atari, and then they got a Sega.
Oh, I think Jeff's family, what did they had an Intellivision, I think.
Ooh.
We had Atari. Well, my brother had Atari. I did not have anything. No. My brother had Atari.
I got my Nintendo, I think, when I was 5 or 6 years old for Christmas.
Was it like the...
Yeah, the little box.
The box, not the Game Boy thing, right?
No, that didn't come out till I was in high school.
Okay.
So, yeah, I had the little box and little controllers. And my parents, which, you know, they actually made really good money when I was a kid. Never upgraded that video game system. I never got the Super Nintendo. I never got the 64. I never got any of those.
They're like, that's good enough.
You only get that one.
Forever.
Forever. I still own it.
Mm.
I just bought something so I will go into my 75-inch TV so I can actually play it on there.
Oh, nice.
Oh, I know. I love that. So Contra, it's a two-player game. One or two player game, and you got about 8 levels you have to get through, and you just got to battle all the way through there. And then at the very end, you kill an alien, and then you destroy the whole island, and you fly off on a helicopter, and you succeeded.
Wow. Okay. So
I can actually, I'm phenomenal at this game. My dad and I used to play this game together all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
We would beat the game so many times. I am the only one in my family that beat it by myself. And wow. I have proven it to Thor multiple times. Since we've been married, mm-hmm, we get it out once in a while when we used to have our old VCR because you have to plug it through the VCR. That's why we just bought the new cord.
Yep.
And I would play it. Well, we just got rid of our VCR a couple years ago, so I couldn't play it. Well, we bought the arcade thing and it has Contra. It sucks on that thing.
It's horrible. Yeah.
So I can also get 30 lives on this thing.
Holy shit.
Oh, yeah. You guys go up, up, down, down, left, right, left, right, A, B, select, start. And then you got 30 lives.
That's called a cheat code. Yes.
But he got it memorized. I have this thing memorized since I was 7.
Damn.
Yes. So that's my favorite game in the whole wide world is that one, Contra.
Holy shit.
I could literally probably plug it in right now and I could beat it. And I can actually challenge it and beat it in my 3 lives that I get.
So I had Frogger.
Oh, God.
I love Frogger.
Yeah, Thor loved Frogger.
And I also love Pitfall. Do you ever play Pitfall?
Never heard about that one until you just said it.
Really?
No, no, no.
So you have, there's a little guy and like you have to walk, you're supposed to just make it through like the jungle. Okay. And so you have alligators that you have to, but you have to like jump like on their noses.
So they keep their mouths closed?
Yeah. And so you have to jump over them. And sometimes you have to crawl down into a tunnel and jump over snakes.
I don't think
stuff.
If you jumped on a crocodile's mouth, it would actually close.
Right.
They're too strong.
But anyways, it was called Pitfall. I think that's what it's called. Okay. That was kind of fun. So I played that. I played Frogger. I didn't play a whole lot of video games.
Did you play Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
No.
You never played that one?
I never played that one. Nope. We didn't have that when I was in school.
How about the Oregon Trail?
Nope.
What?
Nope.
That was with an old school floppy disk.
Nope. So when I was growing up, we didn't even have floppy disks. We had cartridges.
What? I've never heard of that.
Yeah, there's like a cartridge.
For the computer?
Like a tiny. So my brother had a Texas Instruments computer.
Oh.
So you had to take these games, like they had a cartridge you plugged in, like a tiny 8-track that you would just slide in there, like plug that sucker in. And the games, I'm using my quotation fingers, there was no graphics or anything. It just typed out the description of what was happening because there was no graphics.
Oh,
that's how old I am. Okay.
The thing is, it's not a huge difference between us.
I know, but that's what we had.
Yes.
That's what we had.
Because Thor and you, there's even a less difference.
Yeah.
And he had these things growing up.
Yeah. See, no. So that's what we had. Those were the computer games. The Atari, we had the Atari, which did have the graphics, but it was like a Space Invaders and Mission.
You know, Thor and I own a half-ass Atari.
Do you?
Yeah. Like the one you bought with the preloaded games on it.
Yeah.
And so you ever want us to bring it, it's a plug and play. We'll just plug it in. You guys
I did like to play Space Invaders.
Thor loves Space Invaders. You know, we have that on our arcade.
Or Centipede.
We have Centipede and Space Invaders on, and Thor says they play decently on our big arcade game.
Okay.
At home.
I always hated Pac-Man.
Pac-Man, what I don't like about Pac-Man, I don't like games I can actually die in. Does that make sense?
Can't you die in all the games?
Well, no.
Yeah, you can. Okay.
Not the ones I like to play. I mean, like Contra, I don't die. That's the only reason I play that one, but like you won't see me play like a regular one.
Oh.
Because I don't want to die. I don't like the blood going on my screen.
Speaking of games.
Oh, shit.
So I've told you this. I don't know if you remember.
We'll see.
Right now, current day time.
Okay.
One game I like to play is The Sims.
Yes.
It's The Sims 3.
Which she has a character.
And you can buy different
packs. Isn't this the one you have me in?
Yeah. So
yeah, this is fantastic.
So you can buy just The Sims 3 or you can buy add-ons. So I bought on Supernatural where you have vampires and werewolves and zombies.
I love that aspect.
And the World Adventure ones where you get to travel outside of the normal town. Usually all the Sims are in the town, but with the World Adventures, you can go to France,
China,
and Egypt.
You don't want to go to China, though, right now.
So, my Sim, I know you've never played The Sims.
No, I don't really know much about it, but I've heard.
But each Sim has a lifelong dream. Like a lifelong dream you're supposed to help them achieve.
And your Sim is...
So, I created a new Sim.
Yes.
Named
Tell everybody
Heather.
What your Sim is.
And she looks like Heather with the red hair and everything. And her dream was to be, I can't remember what it's called, but basically like a world traveler, like to explore 6 different tombs in each one of these countries.
Tombs?
So you explore the tombs and you find artifacts and stuff like that.
Okay,
so fun. And all of the Sims.
Do I get to find any mummies?
Yes.
Oh, do I get to take them home?
And no, but if you're not careful, the mummy curses you.
Oh.
And if you don't break the curse, you die. So I haven't gotten cursed yet.
Oh, don't kill me.
But and all this. So when you create a sim, you have to assign personality traits.
Oh,
and you get to pick five.
Okay. What did you pick?
So for you, and I knew you were going to be traveling around the world and stuff.
Yes.
So I picked like adventurous.
That's very good.
Okay. I picked athletic.
Okay. So far, these are very accurate.
I picked loves the outdoors.
That's somewhat accurate.
Yes. I picked, what else did I pick?
Hopefully I am good at navigating. Because I'm not good at that in real life.
I can't remember the other two. It might have been like charismatic or something like that, you know, because I knew you were going to be out in the world or whatever.
Is rich in there? Because I need money for this.
That's not a personality trait. So my Heather Sim also.
Your Heather Sim.
My Heather Sim. When you create the Sim, you can decide how they look, right? Like I could pick your hair color and stuff like that. And so
didn't make me fat, did you?
I was doing the body thing, I'm like, I want her to have big muscles, right?
Yes.
So I put the muscle thing all the way up when I clicked okay and started, and I realized it wasn't the muscle.
They made my boobs big.
They made your boobs huge. Like they stick out. Like all of your outfits, I'm like, what's on her? I'm like, oh shit, that's her boobs. I didn't do the muscle one. I did the boob one, and they're just like way out there.
Like we're talking Dolly Parton boobs.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're fucking huge.
So I'm glad I'm athletic because when you have that big of boobs, there's a lot of extra weight to carry.
So I have you work out all the time to try to reduce that. But yeah.
And you can't reduce. You can't change.
You can't. I haven't
figured. So you're stuck with the triple E's.
So you have the ginormous boobs, and apparently, for some reason, you keep catching the kitchen on fire. I don't know why.
Seems accurate.
So like normally, like when you play the Sims game, your Sim will catch the oven on fire once.
Oh,
like it always happens.
But mine catches it.
You always catch the oven on fire once, and you always have a burglar break into your house one time. It always happens in every game.
Do I kill the burglar?
So no.
Oh.
So what you do, and I know this, so I did this right away. I'm like, I installed an alarm system because if you do that, then the police will arrive and arrest the burglar before he can get away with your stuff.
Okay. Oh my
so
God.
So I did that knowing that that would happen.
Yes.
But then of course you set the oven on fire, which always happens and you have to replace it. But then you did it again and then you did it again. I'm like, why does she keep setting the fucking oven on fire? Like, I don't understand. And like, your Sim has skills. And when you do stuff, it raises your skill level in those things.
But apparently,
so I've raised your cooking level up and up and up, and you still keep catching the oven on fire. I don't know why. Like, I'm like, why? I asked Megan, I'm like, cause she plays the Sims all the time. I'm like, why does my Heather Sim keep catching the oven on fire? She's like, I don't know, Mom. Like, she just sucks. I don't know.
So in high school, I almost caught her oven on fire a few times.
So this is accurate, then.
It's accurate.
This is accurate.
I can't have a gas stove.
Okay.
Electric, I do fine with. It's not gas, is it, on your thing?
It doesn't say.
If it's gas, it's why it's
so
happening.
So I think it's electric, but...
I don't know.
Well, like one day you have a job.
Yeah.
So you can't go on your world adventures without money. So you have to have a job.
I have to work.
So for a while you worked for the police department.
Oh shit.
You were like an officer. But you would like get up in the morning starving. You're like making waffles for yourself. You put the waffles in the oven and it's time to go to work. So you just run off to work and you leave them in the oven. I'm like, why did she leave that in the oven? God damn it. And then it's on fire and it's on fire again. But
so
just
you have no control over me?
I can, but like sometimes.
Like, why would you let me go to work without eating?
Well, they honk. The carpool comes and they honk for you and you run off.
Without it's just getting, like, turn the oven off.
I'm like, shit. I don't know.
You have to turn the oven off before I leave.
You just, you know, and then.
Because that's not a normal me. I'm one of these that never leaves anything on.
And then you cook food and you just leave your dirty plates all over the place.
That is not me.
Yeah, you do that.
But that's not me.
You
in
do
real,
that.
Not in real life.
But I want you to know that you left the police force because the military recruited you.
Oh, God. Yeah.
And now you work for the military.
Hopefully I'm a sniper.
It's fantastic.
Am I a sniper?
No.
Fuck.
You're not a sniper.
I'm not like a sex slave in there.
You might be a latrine cleaner. I'm not sure.
Oh, no.
But you have a really nice garden. But since I have
a garden, good.
But since, well, I always, in my Sims, I always make them really good gardeners because if you get really upper level, you can grow money trees.
Oh.
And then you get money and you grow life fruit trees where you can eat life fruit and you never die. So I always.
Wait, your Sims can die?
Yeah, they die. They grow old and die.
What?
Yep.
What happens when they die?
They're dead. The Grim Reaper literally comes and takes you.
Wait. So is your game done then?
Yeah.
Like you have to recreate a new Sim.
Well, hopefully by then you've married and had children because then you also control the children. And you just keep going, but you do die. Yeah.
Wow. Is it accelerated like a dog's life?
It's very accelerated.
Is it more so than a dog's life?
Yes, it's very accelerated.
Like, do the Sim Carrier only live for months?
It's less than that.
Oh, shit!
Like, between, like, well, their day lasts, like, I don't know, the time goes by, like, really fast. Like you going and taking a shower in the Sim game takes an hour. You cooking a meal takes like an hour and a half. Wow. Like it goes, the time goes by like really, really fast.
So it's like a fly life.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So you have your garden and so you're doing that. And since you've been to China a couple times, you also have learned karate.
Oh, good for me.
And so you practice that a lot. Mm. And so that's fantastic too.
The karate is going to do really good
but
when I'm old.
But since I have the supernatural expansion also, when there's a full moon, all these zombies come out of the ground.
And werewolves.
And they eat your garden.
Why would they eat my garden? They want to eat brains.
No, in this game, they eat your garden. So I've made you into kind of an alchemist where you create potions and you create this potion that cures people and you throw it at the zombies and it cures them and they don't eat your garden.
Oh, and then they're real people again. Mm-hmm. They get to go back and live their little lives for another week until they die.
So one of these nights, I'm going to have to show you your Sim.
You are going to have to see
you have to see the boobs. Because they're fantastic.
Because I actually really don't have that big of boobs, sadly.
They're fantastic.
Mm, I'm so excited for that. So, how are we doing?
We're good.
Fantastic.
So we're going to sign off. We're going to go partay.
Partay
with our prime rib.
And our, whatever. Hopefully
it's going to be fantastic.
We're going to buy a couple bottles, I think, at the table.
And we're going to be good.
Yeah, we'll be fine. Everything will be great.
So I hope everybody has a great week. I don't think we said that this was Jether's Random Stuff.
Oh, I'm. She's Kobe and I'm Heather and together we make a Jether.
So sorry about that. That's what you're listening to. Everybody wants to drop us a line. Let us know your favorite game. Let us know if you played The Sims.
Yeah.
If you like them to have big boobs.
Yeah.
All that jazz.
That's really great.
Drop us a line because we would love to hear from you. Jethersonstuff@yahoo.com. That's how you get a hold of us.
That's us. Peace. Bye.